Hi.
Hello guys. So it's been so long. I don't even know how many months, because it's been months. And I don't know. First of all, I just want to apologize and for being absent and not giving you like a reason or giving you like a notice before doing it. But I have had the past months have been like so chaotic, have been like full of ups and downs for me. So it just felt like really overwhelming, and I just needed my space to, I just needed to step aside and like clear my mind, clear my thoughts, my feelings, my mental health as well. And because I was feeling really uninspired as well, I felt like really burnt out at the same time. So I felt like I wasn't in the right space to give you quality content, if you know what I mean. So if you're still here, thank you so much. I've seen that some of you have been gone already, and that's completely okay, no hard feelings. And after I upload this video, I expect some people to unsubscribe as well, but that's completely okay. I totally understand. Sometimes it's good to clear like your subscription list. All right, so I want to start by chronological order and tell you what has been going on with me. Hopefully, like, I don't extend myself too much because I have a lot to say. All right, so in the last vlog that I have in this channel, I was in New Mexico, and I was telling you that I was going to move, but I forgot to tell you where. I already watched the video again, and I was like rolling my eyes because I didn't tell you where, and I didn't give you like context. All right, so before moving to New Mexico, I was living in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, and I ended up moving back there. I love that city, it's just so pretty. I feel that it has so much to offer, and it gives me the vibes of like a big city without the chaos of one, if you know what I mean. For example, New York. It looks so much like it, and actually, this is like a fun fact about that city. I heard someone mention this, and it is the fact that they have chosen that city to film some movies and make it believe that they are in New York, you know what I mean? Because it's cheaper to film in another city that is not New York, in another location. So anyway, that's very interesting, and I just love that city, especially the weather. It's just so nice. You have all the seasons. That's something that I love. I am not a big summer fan. I actually prefer the cold. Fall and winter are my favorite seasons. All right, so yes, I went back to Pittsburgh, and I stayed there for a while. Maybe what, 6 months? I decided to book a trip to Colombia, Medellin, Colombia, my home country, the city that I am from, to finally visit my family after 3 years of not seeing them. Because after the lockdown, the pandemic and everything was so chaotic at airports, so many restrictions. And that was basically the reason why I didn't book a trip earlier. So I was missing my family, and I just decided to do it. All right, so I stayed there for 2 months. If you follow me on Instagram, I posted some reels, some pictures, and it was so much fun. And I started vlogging. I tried to be in the moment as much as I could, and I tried to vlog as much as I could. But I just wanted to be present. It's not the same enjoying the moment than just like be worried about like getting all the footage. But I was able to get some for my whole trip. So I think I have like one whole video of those 2 months that I stayed in Colombia. So if you wanna see that, even though it's been months, you can let me know in the comments down below. I actually went there to celebrate and on the dates of the birthday for my mom, my sister, and my niece. So that was really nice that I was able to like share time with them, and quality time, and it was so good. All right, and when I was kind of ready to go back, to come back here to the US, like 2 weeks prior to coming back, I had to make a really, really hard decision, and it was putting my dog down, Hanny, if you remember him, my cute little fur baby. He was 13 years old, and when I say it was really, really hard, it's because, I mean, the decision of putting him down alone is really hard. But what made it harder for me was not being able to say goodbye properly. I had to do this through FaceTime. So my husband was here in the States and he had to take him to the vet. 3 days prior to that, he was not eating, he wasn't pooping, he wasn't peeing. He wasn't himself. It's like his body was there, but it wasn't him. So we finally made the decision to do it, and it was a decision that we were going like back and forth, because it was confusing because sometimes he would be doing really good, sometimes he would be really, really bad. So I was feeling like, okay, if I put him down right now, because I don't want to prolong his suffering, his pain, I will feel guilty eventually. But at that point, he wasn't doing well. So we made a decision, but I just have to admit that that has been the hardest thing that I have done in my life. And the grief that I've been through has been so big. And I'm not crying right now, I'm trying not to, because I have filmed this part. All this that I'm telling you right now, I have filmed this like four times already, three or four times. And I've cried. Like, I have a little tissue here because I didn't want to be like a mess and mess up my makeup. So anyway, I was crying so much. That was 2 weeks prior coming back here. The next day when that happened, it was my mom's birthday, and that was the whole reason I went to Colombia. And I just had to put a straight face, I remember, to don't ruin my mom's birthday. And after eating and celebrating, we went to the mall, and then I had to see a schnauzer, which is kind of rare, a rare breed, I will say. And Hanny was a standard schnauzer, meaning the medium one, the medium size, a black one, which is extremely rare. And I just found a really cute white one. He was like a miniature, so nice. And I saw the owner and I just saw him like, can I pet him? I had to put mine down yesterday. I'm sorry. And it was so hard, and just at the mall, I was just like bawling my eyes. It was embarrassing as well. So anyway, that happened, and when I came back home is when it really hit me. I was spending most of my time at home. I was not leaving the house, on my bed, crying my eyes out the whole time. I think I went through a really hard period of depression, I think that's what it was. It was depression, you know? It was grief. And I feel this is a little bit controversial because some people say, oh, it's just a pet, it's just a dog, it's just a cat. No, they become part of your family. And when you get to love them so much, it hurts so bad. And here is why I say this. It's because we are humans, we make mistakes and everything. And that's okay. But with them, the pets, they are so there for you. They're like offering you unconditional love. They don't do harm to you, you know? They're just so pure. They're like little angels. And also, Hanny was like a dog that kept me a lot of company, because I don't know if I've spoken about this before, but when I moved to the US, and when you move to another country, you leave your family, everything behind, as I did. It was my own decision, my choice. You get so lonely. And I've always been like a kind of a loner. I like my own space and everything, but I've been missing my family and everything. And Hanny kept me so much company, that dog. I just loved him. And he was my husband's dog. So I only got to spend like 5 years with him. And yeah, he died at the age of 13. Anyway, so I want to move on. And yeah, then after that we started packing, making plans because we were moving again across the country, and we ended up coming to California. So I am in California right now. I am not by the coast, but more like in the middle where it's a little bit drier, like the desert. And yeah, I've been here for what, a month? So I have some packages. I have like a mini haul. Like, I'm trying to give you a little bit of fashion here as well. So I got two packages yesterday that I want to show you. And it's my birthday. I forgot to mention that. Tonight I am going out for dinner. We are going to San Bernardino, which is like 40 minutes away. It's not too far. And it's nice, so we are going there. So I wanted to wear something a little different, especially because most of my stuff is in storage. Like, I only got some dresses, you know, I've been living with the same outfits for what, a month? What feels like a month. So I want to start. Yes, I already opened the packages, and this one I already tried it on, so it doesn't have any tags, but I just got this. All right, so I have this beautiful puff sleeve dress from Abercrombie. So nice. Look at the print that it has. It has red, it has a little bit of print. The background is not completely white. It's more like an ivory or cream color, and just the print is so nice. It has this little detail at the front. You know what I mean? You can take the sleeves down a little and it looks so nice. I already tried it on. It doesn't have a zipper, but it has an elastic in the back. This one I got it in the size a small petite, because they have normal and they have another size like that. But this one is the small in petite. It was the only one that was available because this one was on sale, and I was so glad that I was able to get my hands on this one, because I was eyeing this up for so long. It had a period where it was sold out and it came back, so it's so nice. And actually, I think this one is the one that I'm going to wear tonight. So it is a mini dress, as you can see. It's so pretty, and the best thing is that it has pockets. Can you ask for more? I think you can't. Let me show you where are the pockets. On both sides, which is so nice. And they're deep, actually. And I want to show you that it has lining. It has like something underneath. You don't have to wear a bra with this, which is so nice. And the only thing that I have to say about the sizing is just that this one, for example, is small petite. It's just a little bit tight for me on the chest area. But the other one that I'm going to show you is not so much. So that is the Emerson dress. And I just love the style. And when you love something, just get it in more colors. And that's exactly what I did. This one still has a tag because I will wear this later. So I got the same style in this beautiful beige color. The background is beige, but it has flowers, brown, it has blue, different shades, like different hues, if you know what I mean. The same puff sleeves, but this one I got it in the size a small normal. You know what I mean? So both of them are the size small, but that one is petite. This one is petite, this one is regular. I will say that this one, it fits a little bit better on me around the chest area. It is, remember, this doesn't have a zipper, so it is easier for me to put it on. But if you have like smaller chest, like, you don't have to worry about that. Both of them are currently available. So this one I got it for like $60, maybe under $60, and because it was on sale. And this is full price right now, which is $80. I think it is so nice, especially this one. I got this one to wear it maybe September, October, because here is really, really hot and it doesn't get cold until late October or November. So I will wear this one with sandals, and when it starts getting a little bit cooler, I will wear it with my brown boots, and that will look so nice. So yeah, that's like my mini haul today, guys. I need to start getting ready. Well, I'm kind of ready. I already did my makeup, but I have to change, steam this, and just maybe retouch my makeup. I already have all of my jewelry on, which is so nice, and see you later. All right, guys, so I wanted to show you the dress and the way it looks on. So beautiful, I love it. I am not wearing a bra right now, and it's just like perfect. I don't need it. This is thick here, so I'm making sure I'm not flashing you with something. yeah, so this has like extra fabric here, and the extra layer that I showed you, it has the white one, and it's just like plenty, so nice. And this is the way it looks. This is my outfit for tonight. We are going out for dinner, so I want to give you the details. So of course, my Lady Dior that I got for my last birthday. This year I am planning on giving myself something not this big, nothing this crazy, but I just love it so much, and I thought I would wear it today. And I am wearing my Stuart Weitzman sandals. They are nude sandals. It's a little bit difficult because I am against the light, but you can see that they are nude, and I thought they will go really, really well with this look. I thought of wearing black ones, but I didn't want like the straps of the heels like making me look short, like cutting my legs. So that's why I went for nude. This is so dark because I am against the light. And I want to show you the lipstick that I'm wearing. So this is the Rouge Dior lipstick, the 999, the classic red lipstick. But I really like the red lipstick. I love a red lipstick, especially with my dark hair now, with the black hair. And this is the perfect shade of red lipstick because it's not too cool tone. It doesn't look like a coral tone, but it's definitely warm. So I really like that. And guys, I forgot to tell you that you can actually like take the sleeves down and wear your dress like this, but I just prefer the puff sleeves up. It looks nicer in my opinion. And I also wanted to show you the jewelry that I'm wearing today. So these are the Idol. This is the stud, and this is the Coco add-on, which is so beautiful, and I often wear it just as my necklace. This is the necklace as well, all 14K gold. But today I just decided to wear the earrings like this because it is a special occasion and it looks so nice. Okay, so really quickly, I want to show you or give you a sneak peek of this house. You're probably curious. So this is it. That's the dining room, the kitchen. It's beautiful, so big, I love it. A bedroom / office over there, the living room, bedrooms over there, and I have this huge fireplace here with this huge dead space that I don't know what to do with. It is 11:30 right now, and I have to say that last night I had so much fun with my dinner. I ended up having my birthday dinner. I ended up having the ribeye steak. It wasn't that good, to be honest. I've had better ones, but it's okay. The staff was really nice. I loved the ambience of the restaurant. It is at the top of the hill, so you can see the city of San Bernardino. You can see the sunset, the mountains. It is so nice. I'm going to the storage unit to pick up the rest of the stuff that we have there. We have a TV, my desk, my clothes, a treadmill. So we actually rented a U-Haul truck to pick up everything and get it done in an hour, I would say.
And the second reason, maybe the main reason I'll say, that we're getting this today is because this weekend, Hurricane Hillary is hitting California. So Saturday, Sunday, and Monday, it is happening and it's hitting my city. I think right now it's hitting all the coast, LA, San Diego, and everything, and they're experiencing like bad stuff. So it's gonna hit my city. I am in the high desert. I am in the middle of the desert. And we are going to experience maybe some flooding, heavy rains, strong wind, and yeah, probably the power is gonna go out. Probably we won't have any Wi-Fi, which is annoying. So I'll make sure to have like my books there available, my physical books, so that can entertain me. So it just sucks because I am always terrified of natural disasters. For example, when I was living in Alaska, when I just got here to the US, I experienced the worst earthquake. It was 7.2 with the warning of a tsunami because we were surrounded by water when I was living in Anchorage, Alaska. And it was awful. It was so traumatizing. The whole house was shaking, cracks in the walls. It was awful. And I know that California is also known for the earthquakes and now the hurricanes. So I am not very happy about it. Why didn't this happen before me being here? But yeah, let's pray to God that nothing bad happens. So that's what's happening. That's what I'm doing. I think I'm talking too much. I was just applying some sunscreen all over my body. I was using the Banana Boat. I really, really like this sunscreen, and it works well for the body, for the face as well, especially underneath of makeup. It doesn't leave the white cast, and it's not so greasy. So I really like it. And for the face, I've been using the La Roche-Posay, which I actually have to get a new one. And I just want to reapply a little bit of my my lip glow, Dior Addict. And I love this because it has the effect, gives me the feeling, a mix of chapstick and Vaseline with color. So it's just so nice. Vaseline sometimes is too heavy, sometimes chapstick is not hydrating enough, and this is just like perfect. I love it, and it gives you a good amount of color. This is in the shade 001. I feel that sometimes it's just way too pink for me. It's nice, but I would like to explore more colors. One of those colors is Rosewood, I think that's the name. Traffic is already getting crazy.
Okay. And can I also get the pumpkin loaf, please?
Oh, thank you.
No fork, so I'll use a napkin.
The truck looks like in the inside, nothing fancy, very old looking.
Sometimes we have bad experiences with these trucks. At least this one has air conditioner and it doesn't smell bad, because sometimes it smells bad and it's really, really bad. But it is really dirty. So for this trip, my husband is usually driving it. I am always the passenger. I don't feel I can drive something like this. I'll be really scared. And right now we don't have Hanny, my dog, but in past times he was riding here with us in the middle. And for this trip it was kind of weird not to have him there. Gosh, I miss my baby boy so much. And I don't want to start crying, so bye. So this is what I have here, the treadmill, the gym equipment, the squat rack, weights over there, my vanity desk that I need so bad, some of my clothes. I am glad that I label everything pants, shirts with that kind of tape. I can't remember the name in English. The TV stand back there. Hello there. So it's been 2 days, maybe three, I forgot, since the last day I saw you. All I have to say is that everyone was freaking out, the city was freaking out, there was so much bad traffic that day that we were dealing with the U-Haul and everything, because everyone was panicking. The gas stations were full, grocery stores, Costco was like so packed, and basically nothing happened. We just got like heavy rain, really strong wind, but that's it. It was really, really cloudy, which is kind of rare because the sky here is always so blue, like no clouds whatsoever. And yeah, but that's it. And I'm really, really glad because I was kind of scared. I don't like these natural disaster things. But I heard that, I think it was LA, got an earthquake, which I'm really glad that we didn't feel. All right, guys, so today I am going, right now, I am going to go to watch the Barbie movie. I've seen so much stuff about Barbie. It's like they are bombarding you with Barbie stuff. The marketing has been like great, I will say. I kind of want to watch it. I'm kind of interested. I am hoping that it's not like too childlike, you know, targeted for kids. But I've heard that it's more like the story is more like for adults. It's like inspiring or stuff like that. That's why I'm interested. I am also picking up my birthday present. And I am getting the AirPods Pro, the second generation, because the ones that I've had for what, 5 years now, the left side quit working, the microphone is not working, the volume is really low, and it's just like so annoying, and I am always using those. So it is time to upgrade. So I quickly want to show you my outfit. So this is what I'm wearing today. This top is from Zara Super Old. I actually have to get new ones and maybe go a size up because these are a little tight here around the chest area. But I love these and I want to get more colors as well. The shorts are the Ibiza shorts from Aritzia. I am always wearing these. I love them. They are so comfortable. And the Hermes sandals, the Orion sandals from Hermes. And this is something that I have been wearing this whole summer, like nonstop. And I am talking about this beautiful bag made, handmade, by the indigenous people from Colombia. This is something that is very, very traditional. I've seen celebrities here in the US wearing these kind of bags, which are, I mean, Colombian, you know, I'm proud of this. This is like so nice. I actually went for the neutral colors to be able to pair the bag with the rest of my outfits, my wardrobe, and I really, really like it. It's just like so pretty. And inside is just like a bucket bag. So this is it, no bag, nothing, and you get the receipt in your email or in a text message, but these are it. I'm so happy.